So we're testing out some copies of Nestball today. Hey Sam. So Nestball is one of the cards in Sun and Moon that is available online already. It takes a basic Pokemon out of your deck and puts it right onto your bench. Right, we're on the play here. Have Mulligan, no basics. Alright, we've got a Salamence here. Sounds okay. Not stellar, but fine. I would love to draw a Dark Energy. Shaman's not the worst. So, what are we doing here? I can go ahead and Ultra Ball, discarding Dark Patch and Sycamore. We're going to get a Darkrai out of our deck here. One of our dragon energies, one of our dark energies is prized. So I can put this Darkrai on the bench. I can put this Fighting Fury belt on him. I can slide this Reverse Valley out here. Can play the Shaman and draw five cards. Evening Money. And that's a lot of energies. I just want to put this on here and then just go ahead and Sycamore. If we had a Dark Patch, we can bring those back from our discard pile. No Dark Patch. I'm gonna go ahead and start on Trainer Mail here, see what we find. Well, there's Nest Ball, so we can go ahead and play that out here and get another Darkrai for ourselves. This grabs a basic out of our deck and puts it on the bench. So I'm just gonna go ahead and grab the other Darkrai EX here. Which will give this a free retreat cost. Can go ahead and Elixir here and Brick. And then I think I'm actually just going to pass the turn here. I don't really want to play out a second Shaman. I already played an energy for the turn. I guess I could switch this in case they can attack. That doesn't seem awful. And actually, I'm just going to retreat this to the Shaman here on my bench. Hey, Reavar. So, like, pull this back in case I don't really want this to get attacked. This will probably be a relevant attacker at some point. All right, so that's actually really bad for us. They bench locked us here. I guess we have a Verseeker for the Sycamore to power through these cards in our hand, but I don't actually have a way to get rid of this because my two stadiums in this deck are this one Reverse Valley and a parallel city of my own. It's a little unfortunate. Okay, so they've been to Shaman and a Trainer Mail for their Ultra Ball. We're really looking to just like get some dark patches and some elixirs going here. I'm doing well, Guitar Guy. Life is swell. Okay. So my opponent's got two EX Pokemon out now, so this Salamence is up to doing 110 damage when it attacks with Dragon Fang. Still not quite sure what my opponent has going on over here. If they get one more EX out here with a Fighting Fury belt. This will be lethal to the Keldeon. They discarded our one Fighting Fury belt here, but we've got two more in the deck. Possibly. End's actually pretty good here. Hand's kind of bad. So they shuffle their hand in and draw six. Then I'll shuffle our hand in and draw six. They ditched a bunch of energies. I wonder if they're like an M Scizor deck or just something I haven't seen before. Dowsing Machine's not bad. This will let us get a Dark Patch from our discard pile back. Put a Metal Energy on there. Okay. So what am I doing? I think I'm gonna start on Trainer Mail and see what we find. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm in the market for Sycamore. Yeah, that's probably fine. Although I guess I could just grab the escape rope, but nah, I don't wanna do that. Yeah, I'm just gonna grab the Sycamore here. And then I'm gonna go ahead and put this double dragon on here. And then I'm gonna dousing machine ditch these two, grab the dark patch back out of my discard pile here. Peace, Briz. I'm gonna go ahead and play dark patch, which brings this back from my discard pile onto this dark right here. And I'm gonna go ahead and Sycamore, I think. That's really unfortunate. Well, I guess we hit an escape rope, which is pretty good. Because I can rope here to my Salamence, and then that'll knock out either of his bench Pokemon. I'm going to go ahead and put a Fury Belt on here for now, and then go ahead and rope. Play Eternal. I just. The constructed Eternal is kind of frustrating, so I just haven't really been interested in it. So this has 110, so I'm just going to crack him for 120 here. He's got two EXs plus 10 from the Fighting Fury Belt. We'll grab two prizes here. Kind of interesting that he like offered up that Shaymin as a knockout there. Another Metal Energy. Not quite sure what my opponent's building up to. It's probably going to be an N. Yeah. So they're going to end, shuffle away our hand. That's fine. This hand's medium. It's possible I should have played this Fighting Fury Belt out, but I really didn't want to get Mega Horned again. But a lot of these decks also only play one Mega Horn, so maybe I should have just played that out. Very, very possible. God, those are some good hits. All right, and that's another good hit. All right, let's see if either of these work. Nope, miss. I don't have that many darks in my deck right now. All right, we hit on that one, which is sweet. So I get to put this here. And then I get to go ahead and dark patch. I wouldn't be surprised if they concede here, honestly, onto here. And then I can play a double dragon out on here. And now I've got 6, 7, 8, 9. So this dark ray is just hitting for like a cool 200 here. Still not quite sure what my opponent's doing, but 200 you. Grab these two prizes. N and Ultra Ball not really going to do a whole lot, but we also don't really need to do much. We just get to keep one-shotting all the stuff they're putting out. During your turn before you attack me, put a tool card from your hand attached to this Pokemon. And sure, shuffle away my three cards and don't do anything. I guess the energy kind of does something. Wish I would have put that, I'd love a Verseeker or a Lysander. Hey! What's this say? It's your turn before you attack me, but. So that's what they're trying to do? That doesn't seem particularly powerful. So, because I hit this Lysander, I can just Lysander up this Genesect here, and then. This isn't going to kill me, right? So Rapid Blaster. If he can put one more on here, he can one-shot this. That's unfortunate. So my not putting the Fighting Fury Belt on here almost cost us this game. Thankfully, we can just put this up and then Dark Pulse it. And then that's an EX Pokemon, so we get to go ahead and collect our last two prizes here. So, start was clunky, got Paralicity locked, won anyways. Hope everyone's having a good evening. Not gonna be a long stream tonight. I was just gonna sign on and play around with this deck with Nest Ball and expand it anyway, so I figured I might as well stream a little bit of it. I think Nest Ball is everything this deck wants to be doing. I would like to go first. Thank you. And Mulligan. No basics equals a Mulligan. Yeah, not a shame to start. Guess I'll go ahead and put Giratina up here and put Darkrai out on the bench. And actually, I have an N in my opener, which is very good since I mulliganed. My opponents get to draw an extra card, and then we'll get to end that extra card away from them. And shuffles both players' hands into their deck, and then each player draws a card for the remaining prizes. So at the start, we each shuffle six in our hands in and draw six. So I'm just gonna go ahead and Ultra Ball here and ditch these two energies. And putting energies in the discard pile is actually pretty good because it means that when we draw dark patches, we have things to dark patch back. So let's do that. Let's play this out. Let's go ahead and Max Elixir and hit. Sweet. Let's power that up. Let's Max Elixir again. Hit again. Sweet. Power up that same guy. Just go ahead and N. I draw six cards. They put their hand back and draw some new ones. Go Go ahead and put this out here. Put this out here. Don't I put this Fighting Fury belt on someone? I feel like I do. I'm just gonna go ahead and put this on here and pass the turn. So these ropes seem like they're kind of clunky against. They're kind of not really needed with this dark ray here, but we want the rope to get around things like Jolteon, basically. I probably should have retreated that last turn. All right, what am I doing here? So this dousing machine. Yeah, I'm gonna Sycamore anyway, so I'm gonna go ahead and use this dousing machine to get this max elixir back to my hand. And then this, like, good chance this misses. All right, it didn't. But, in the event that it did, I was still just gonna discard it to Sycamore anyway, so, like, it's not a big loss. That's a whole bunch of nest balls. Well, let's get the nest going here. This gets any basic out of our deck onto our bench. Grab that. How's it going, Maddie? Yeah, I was just gonna play a few games before bed anyway, so I figured I might as well stream. Grab another Dark Ray. I haven't played that out yet. Trainer mail. Am I trainer mailing into anything specific is the question I need to ask myself. And I don't think I need, like, it would just be like a dark patch. I guess there's a lot of dark patches in my deck or an elixir, so yeah, I guess there's a lot of hits of things I would use this turn. Yeah, I'll grab the reverse valley for now. So what does this equipment do he's got on here? Attacks this do 30 more or two active EX. So I don't think I'm gonna play. I'm attacking for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 120. This only has 70 hit points. Yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and retreat to this. And I'm not gonna play this reverse valley out here. And the reason why I'm not doing that is because I want to kind of save this until I either need the 10 points of damage or until my opponent has a thing up that I need to get rid of. One thing I do have to watch in this matchup is that these are weak to fighting, so their attacks hit very hard. Switch this to one of your bench Pokemon. And sure. So this is going to hit us for 80. If there's a stadium card in play, it's access 60 more. Oh, that's a reason to not play out stadiums. Okay, Dark Patch, Elixir, Muscle Bands. This is hitting for 120. Robo Substitute. That's annoying. All right, so I don't have a Lysander in here, so I'm looking for a Lysander with this trainer mail, basically. Fighting Fury Belt. Yep, that's probably fine. Let's go ahead and use this. Swing and a miss. That's fine. We were expecting those to start missing here soon, anyways. We can Dark Patch, grab this and put it on here. Can only go on a dark Pokemon. Can go ahead and put this on Hydreigon. I'm gonna go ahead and put this Fighting Fury Belt on Hydreigon for now, and then I'm gonna go ahead and Sycamore and draw 7 new cards. Another Dark Patch. Okay. Yeah, let's just Dark Patch again here. Grab that, put it on here. And then I'm gonna go ahead and just retreat this back. Put this up, knock out his substitute. I'm only through one of my escape ropes, so I don't get a prize for this because this is just a Robo substitute. This card can't retreat. Oh, this can't retreat. Huh, maybe I'm just supposed to leave that there, actually, until I can get set up and Lysander this thing. That's very possible. Like, now I just, like, let him distribute damage, basically, and that doesn't seem like it's particularly good. Yeah, huh. I think I might just pass here. Maybe just, like, Verse Seeker this N. I guess I could Verse Seeker the N and hit my other escape rope. That seems fine. Another energy in here? There is. Alright. Let's dark patch this onto here. And then, yeah, I think I'm just going to retreat this. This says I can't retreat, right? Am I supposed to just put this up? Yeah, I'm probably just supposed to put this up. He's only got so many of these stupid things, right? So if he's got a DCE, he can use Wreck on this. Focus Sash. Pokemon is knocked out. It would be knocked out. It becomes 10 instead. Interesting. So he's coalescing to draw 7. We've got 2 Lysanders in our deck. I'd really like to hit one of those. Now he's got this stupid thing on there. Oh, I think I took my Tool Scraper out of this deck when I added Nest Ball too. That was probably dumb. Yeah, I'm just going to grab this N and N again here. There's a free retreat cost too. All right, well, yeah, I think we just rope here. He'll switch to this, and I can take the stupid item off of it. All these are just dealing infinite damage anyway, so it really doesn't matter. If I let him... I let him knock one of these out. He gets to collect some prizes, and then my ends take him down in cards, which is nice. Well, I'm glad Hydreigon's still alive, because that thing's super annoying. I wonder if both my Lysanders are prized. That would be pretty savage. There are like 16 cards in my deck, and we're seeing 5 of them here. They must both be prized. I feel like that's the only explanation for like not having seen them yet. Should be pretty unfortunate. Let me put this on here. Yeah, maybe I should have put that on there. It probably doesn't matter really. I'm gonna play. Do I want to? I really don't want to play a stadium out because of that stupid thing. I'll go ahead and grab N. Let's see if there's Lysander in my deck. I feel like yeah. It must just not be in here. To go ahead and put this on here, I suppose, and then knock out his stupid thing again. He's got another one of these belts on here to prevent this from dying in one hit. Man, we're gonna lose this game. That's really unfortunate. Oh. Like, play 2 Lysanders for this exact reason, too. Oh, it's just like doing casual 100 balls. That's funny. Yeah, the opponent's deck doesn't seem particularly good. It's just the... either of the 2 cards that we have that let us end this. We didn't hit the escape rope soon enough. I guess I could have played an energy out here to draw one more card, but I'm pretty convinced we just don't have a Lysander in our thing at this point. Yeah, they must just both be prized, right? I'm going to do this and just confirm that they're both prized. Nope, there was one in there, but unfortunately... we have now lost the game. I guess I could have, like, waited and, like, bobbed and weaved, but, like, he only has to knock out one more of our guys. Man, that's really unfortunate. So, like, we had, like, 16 cards, sub-16 cards in our deck, and we end 3 different times in there. So we, like, had, like, 16 choose 5 3 different times and missed the card we were looking for. Every time? That's really sad. The fact that we miss Lysander just long enough, combined with his guys having dealing double damage, it's like I can't imagine his deck ever being able to deal enough damage to a lot of these decks without having weakness on them. All the fighting decks I've played against seem like they don't have a very high raw power level, but they're like strong enough against the Darkrai deck because they're dealing double damage that they can usually take wins off of me. Yeah, this hand's fine. It's got would love to draw an energy on our first draw, so that way we can bin it to Ultra Ball and then use this Dark Patch before we end, but even if we don't, I can't remember if we're on the play or not. I'm gonna play this Hydreigon out just in case we're on the draw. How's Robo? They just kept drawing Robo substitutes. We just didn't have enough time to beat through all of them, basically. Okay, so opponent's playing a Yveltal deck. Could be another Darkrai deck. Reverse Valley is annoying. That means we can't play our Reverse Valley out. The Fury Belt, yep. So that card takes all of the items out of your opponent's hand and shuffles them back into their deck, and then they get to draw a card for each item they took away. So they took four cards out of our hand and then drew four cards. Things that don't feel good for 100. I'm really glad we have this N. They have a really good start here on the play. And they emptied their hand. If I want to end, I have to give them six new cards. That's, oh, things that don't feel good. Yep, that's why I'm playing mostly expanded for the next week or so. I'm planning to play that regional event, and then our new hand here is not particularly good. Parallel City. I mean, I guess it knocks this out, I guess, and takes the Shaymin off his bench. It means he can't play more stuff out. It's still not very exciting. It just like makes our Salamence worse later. I could have taken the Sycamore for next turn, and perhaps that's right. Scale of 1 to dead. Looking like we're certainly dead. And then cards like this, I don't like. A lot of the decks only play one copy of this card, and like while it's like insane on the first turn of the game, like my opponent just played there, like playing this card after the first turn of the game is so unimpressive a lot of the time. I don't understand why you'd play like why if like you want to get people with it, you wouldn't be playing multiple of them. Lysander, sure. So we're gonna swap up my one with an energy on it, I assume. Okay, Trainer Mail says Ultra Ball. Okay, that's a Shaymin at least. Have to draw five cards. So I'm gonna go ahead and Dark Patch here. So I wanna get or I'm gonna go ahead and Dowsing Machine because I wanna get Dark Patch in my discard pile. I think I'm gonna Nest Ball for the other Darkrai first, though. I guess I have a Salamence in here too, technically. He's only got two EXs, so I'm just gonna grab the Darkrai that lets me retreat for free. And then I'm gonna go ahead and Dowsing Machine and bin both of these, and then hopefully this Trainer Mail is gonna find another Dark Patch. Alright, I'll take an elixir. Hopefully this elixir is good. I just slide two energies out onto this guy. Sweet. So elixir hits. So we need to deal 130 to this dork. So that's how many energies? It's six energies or a fighting fury belt and five energies. Good sycamore here could do it. Does this qualify as a good sycamore? It might. We have two energies in here, don't we? Nope, just one. That's unfortunate. So dark patch, that works guaranteed. Put this here. I'm gonna go ahead and retreat this for this, and then I'm gonna go ahead and max elixir. Please hit. 1, 2, 3, 4. So if the elixir would have hit there, or if we had one more energy in here, we'd be able to knock this out in one hit. Okay, I guess I'm just gonna play this out and then hit for 110. It feels really bad. Just like short in two different ways. Today was my first regular article. I'm gonna be writing for them once or twice a month. I'm still card market is still my regular gig, but gonna be giving SCG some content too. They asked me if I was interested in doing it, and I think I can do 5 to 6 articles a month without stretching myself too thin. I've always had the opinion that like I'd rather just not write than write crap, so. Acrobike's interesting. It's a neat way to enable Dark Patch. He says as his opponent discards a dark energy to Dark Patch. All right, good game's opponent. I'm just gonna go ahead and concede. We just got slaughtered at every point this game and just came up just short enough. The turn one get all your items on the play was pretty good. Man, look at all these dark Pokemon. Or all these Pokemon. This sand's actually very bad. It just doesn't do anything outside of play some Pokemon out. There's a lot of draws in our deck that make this hand very reasonable, though. Ultra Ball and Sycamore. Sycamore's actually not that great. We're on the play, so I don't need to play both of these out. Dark Energy is not one of those hands that makes this reasonable. This is gonna. It's. Oh, you know what? I should have put Salamence as my active because this means if a stadium gets out, this is a free retreat cost. Small mistake on my part. This is a Triv deck that my opponent's playing. This says I can't play items. That's a Crushing Hammer. So they item lock you and then try and knock your energies off. This deck my opponent's playing really it doesn't do a whole lot. It just like nickel and dimes you to death, basically. This is probably a shaman. Yep. So I can't play these Verse Seekers now. Man, tough night. Some bad hands. It's possible one of the things that I changed when I like redid things in this deck is we do have slightly less draw. It's possible I want like a third N. I'm on 4 Sycamore and 2 N right now. It's possible. I just want to see another N. Well, there's that. And I definitely this was a mistake. I should have put this up as my active for sure. Although I don't think I can play stadiums while this is out. No, I can play stadiums. Okay. Yeah, my opponent's basically playing like a lock deck. I don't have a lot going on right now either, though. What does this attachment do? Any damage done to this Pokemon is reduced by 20. Okay. And now, if I would have started with my Salamence up here, I would be able to retreat this for free right now, and then I would get to attack for lethal, right? It would be 1, 2, 3, 4. That's ideal. Yeah, I'd be able to hit him for the... I'm just going to go ahead and concede. I started with the wrong Pokemon up, and that's basically the end of it. I would have been able to switch my Salamence for free because he played a stadium, and then knock their guy out in one shot. Lots of really little mistakes that you can easily make. No basics. I have to mulligan. We get a few more awkward hands, and I'll probably throw another N in here. Nest balls seem okay so far. Like, not super impressive, but like every time we've drawn it, it's been fine. We might not need 4 of them. Opponent's got Yevital Sleeves. What are the odds they're playing Yev? So we'd like to find like an Ultra Ball with this so we can discard down and then play the Shaman out. Elixir would be great if we find Ultra Ball. God, just another hand that doesn't do anything. I'm just going to take nothing here, and then I'm going to put this on here, and then I'm going to play this Shaman to draw a pathetic 2 cards. Well, there's an N, I guess. Maybe I'm supposed to escape rope this out here. Yeah, it's very possible I'm supposed to escape rope this out. Alright, well, we hit with that at least. And I guess, like, I haven't had a Nest Ball in any of these hands, so, like, if there was a Nest Ball, if I'm, like, cutting a Nest Ball for an N, like, these hands would still be the same. So everyone's playing a dark fighting deck. Sableye, flip a coin, put 2 items from your discard pile into your hand. That's pretty good. Jirachi. Change for a free type, play the top 5 cards of your deck, put them back in any order. Put a fighting Pokemon from your discard pile onto your bench. Hidden ball trick, and then draw 5 cards. Oh, so they're cheating this into play. If you played a supporter card from your hand this turn, this attack does plus 70 damage. Ooh, that's... And... Of course my guys are weak to fighting. So he's stacking the top 5 cards of his deck right now. Gotta assume there's double colorless energy in his deck so he can just attack with this. Did he just... Oh, this is the one that takes extra, right? Okay, so what am I doing here? This stream has been gas so far, right? So I think I actually want to end here rather than Sycamore because my opponent just stacked the top 5 cards of their deck and this shuffles their deck. So that seems like a worthwhile investment. I'm going to go ahead and Nest Ball here. Yep. Grab this other Dark Ray. So, yeah, that feels okay. Go ahead and play this Dark Ray out. And then... Go ahead and Dark Pulse, I guess, just for like 80. It's not great, but it's not awful either. I guess if he's able to swap this out, he's going to be able to one-hit KO this because of the weakness. So maybe this isn't a great attack. This is totally a reanimator deck. Your opponent can't play Pokemon from his or her hand to evolve. It's got like a bunch of different utility guys, like just heavy hitters and stuff. Okay, there's an N. I'm okay with that. My hand is not great. Like, Double Dragon's okay, and I guess I hit a Verseeker for N, but like this Dark Patch isn't doing anything. I think I need to go back up to 4 Ultra Balls in the deck. I keep having Dark Patches stuck in my hand, and just like no way to get Dark Energies into my deck. Which is definitely a problem. We're gonna make some changes after this. I think we're gonna swap back up to 4 Ultra Ball and add another N. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and play this Nest Ball out, which has just been solidly medium. This might be better in the standard deck than this version, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm gonna go ahead and Escape Rope here, I think, and see what they put up. It's like a poor man's. Okay, so they put that guy up. I'm going to go ahead and put Salamence up because it can retreat for free. I'm going to go ahead and put this on here. And then again, I'm going to end because they just stacked the top of their deck. Hitting two of these in my hand's a little awkward with Elixir. This is probably going to brick now. Yeah, we are a professional at bricks. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So... I mean, this is lethal at least. We got that going for us. Collect one of them Dare prize cards. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go down to 2 Nest Ball and then play 4 Ultras and 3 Ns. So I assume this is about to get a double colorless energy and then just like knock me out. There's been a bunch of supporters, so probably gonna see a VS Seeker here for whichever supporter they want. They've been Delinquent, Kidus, and N. Geddes really doesn't do much right now. Dark Patch, sure. They're really sliding this out to attack with. He patched it and he played an energy on it. I guess he hasn't played a supporter yet. There's the VS Seeker. So what are we going to get? N, sure. I'm going to be down a card from this, but my hand was solidly medium, which I keep saying, so maybe I... This deck, good chance this deck's just not very good. Which packs are used by our first deck? Roaring Skies you can basically trade for whatever you want. It's kind of like the de facto like best currency kind of. So I've got a Fury Belt. We have 2 Fury Belts here. I've got a Lysanders. The Lysander are gonna be useless. This has 150, so I need 6 energies to one hit KO, and I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 energies, so if I draw an energy next turn, we can knock this out. So this is going to do 60 to this and probably 60 to the Shaman. Might need a Fury Belt. Oh no, we're hitting the Giratina. Okay, interesting. So I can Fury Belt here, and then I can Fury Belt here. Because why not? Oh, these tools don't have effect while this is up, sure. But I'm gonna knock this out, right? This only has 170, so I'm going to hit it for 90. I'm hitting for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so that's 100, 120, 130, this is 140. Yeah, I guess I'm just going to KO his guy here. I'm going to slide the Reverse Valley out here just so we can stop drawing it. I don't think it's going to be super relevant. And go ahead and Dark Pulse. There is a thread on the Pokemon TCG forums of a shop-like place that has almost every card in stock, and you can they have values listed on there for like which packs are worth what amount, and you basically just make a post in that thread saying what you want and then which packs you're willing to trade for it. All right, so that's going to one-hit KO this, which does not feel good. You're going to take guys off my bench. Yeah, that's fine. So I'm going to go ahead and lose this, and I think I have to keep this. So this will do 130 with a bonus. So if I hit another double dragon, that's good. Oh, I guess I take the two items out of my hand. I kind of wanted that Ultra Ball. So he hits for 260 here, which is more than enough to knock the Darkrai out, obviously. Oh, he's stacking the top five cards of his deck, sure. Dark energy. Well, we going Lysander this guy. Hope for the best. I'm going to play this out. I'm going to play this out. I'm going to retreat this to Salamence since this has damage on it and this has a free retreat cost thanks to this Darkrai. Computer search, sure. Like, the world is his oyster here. He's, like, stripped our resources down. Maybe we can get paired against a non-fighting deck. How's it going this evening? We are getting destroyed. Which, you know, is good. We're doing almost a little bit too much winning. And I made a number of changes to the deck. I added the Nest Balls in, which is four cards is a lot. That's, like, you know, almost 10% of the deck that's different now. I think four Nest Balls was too many for this deck for sure. Alright, so we're going to pick up our Yev, and then we're going to slide that forward, sure. Whoa! Okay, no, he's just stacking, so I was like, if he's attacking, that's super aggressive, because he hasn't played another bench guy out yet. Yeah, like I said, it's almost certainly a large part of this is deck building mistakes, and one of them I put the wrong Pokemon as my active to start, and that definitely cost me. Yep, 130, sure. Hey, look, not one of the cards we needed. All right, let's make some changes here. So. Yeah, so the Pokemon suite alone. We're going to cut to back down on the Nest Balls. Go back up to four Ultra Ball. I think I'm going to go to another N here. And honestly, the way these games are playing out, I think the computer search is better than the Dousing Machine. I could be wrong on that, but the Dousing Machine's been solid, solid medium. The Dousing Machine seems like it would be good, like, when we've got a lot of stuff going on, but, like, when we don't have anything going on, like, there's definitely been hands where, like, if the Dousing Machine had been computer search, we'd have been way better off. I would like to go first. Thank you. And mulligan number one. Peace, Betty. mulligan number two. Hopefully we have one of our three ends in the opener, so we can take away our opponent's extra cards. Yeah, this is fine. So I'll go ahead and lean on Hydrian here. Would like to find an end with this. Opponent gets to draw two extra cards here because we had to mulligan twice. Another Sycamore. I'm going to lead on Nest Ball here. I'm going to grab... Yeah, I'm just going to grab... I'm just going to grab this Dark Rite. My opponent's playing Night March. Okay. Trainer Mail here. See what we find. Computer Search. Yeah, if you... There aren't... So you don't buy cards for money directly, but if you go on the Pokemon TCG forums, you can... There are groups of people that they price all of the cards at varying amounts, and then you can trade... I think I'm going to get a computer search here. And then you can trade specific packs for the cards you want specifically. Crypt. Hex TCG calls the discard pile the Crypt. And that's the one I play the most, so like that's like my default go-to. What am I computer searching for here is the question. I think it's been these two. I could just like grab another elixir here. That doesn't seem awful. And then I can just like elixir, and then Sycamore. Haven't played an energy out yet, so I can go ahead and put this Dark Ray on my bench, and then what am I doing here? This Fighting Fairy Belt's kind of useful. Actually, I should have powered up this Dark Ray in this matchup, because knocking out these Joltics off their bench is actually kind of relevant. It's a bit of a mistake. So I'm certainly Ultra Balling here. The question is, do I want to discard both of these? Yeah, actually, I can get rid of both of these. I really don't care about getting double dragon energies going, because I don't need that much damage to be knocking out the Pokemon my opponent's playing. Let's go ahead and bring this dark energy back from my discard pile onto here. Go ahead and play Shaman and draw a bunch of cards. Solid, solid turn one. And opponent got bored and conceded because we were setting up. All right, sure. Free points are free. Yay! Chests or something. I would just like to say good morning, afternoon, and good night to everyone, wherever you're out in the world. Thanks for choosing to spend part of your day here with us. We battle some Pokemon TCG. My name is Jeff Hoagland. I'm a professional gamer, and here on this channel, we stream all sorts of card games, Pokemon, Hex, Magic. If you're enjoying the content, you're new to the channel, I encourage you to show a little bit of support by using that follow button there on the screen. It doesn't cost you anything and helps other people find my content. If you're really enjoying what you see and you want to step up that support a little bit, you can use that subscribe function there for $4.99 a month. It helps support myself financially so I can stream more, as well as the Twitch infrastructure that we all use and enjoy on most days. This stream is also sponsored this month and next month by the Super Rodcast. They're a competitive focused Pokemon TCG podcast, so if you're looking to get a little bit more involved in Pokemon TCG or just learn about better decks and up your game a little bit, be sure to give them a listen on iTunes and SoundCloud and Twitter and Facebook. That is the Super Rodcast. This hand is... It's fine. Like, Shaman as our opener is not particularly exciting, but, like, we've got an Ultra Ball to get our bench set up. We've got a Trainer Mail to hopefully find a Dark Patch or an Elixir to get a little bit of acceleration going. Opponent's playing some kind of Psychic deck here. My first IRL Pokemon TCG tournament, I went 4-2 playing Dark Ray Dragons in the standard format. Speaking of subscribers, Drew.Druid with the 10-month resubscription. Welcome back, buddy. I appreciate the continued support. I went 4-2 at my first Pokemon TCG tournament, and I finished in ninth place out of 46 players. Had six rounds of Swiss. I lost to a Grenja deck and a Volcanion deck. And I didn't actually lose to the Volcanion part of the Volcanion deck. I lost to what was it? They had a Salamence in their deck that was just very good and just destroyed me. Opponent's either in the tank or AFK. Would like to draw an extra card, thank you. Opponent's playing Night March again. Okay, well, let's lead on Ultra Ball here and discard these dark energies again. Want to prioritize getting some darks into my crypt so I can. There's only one dark ray in my deck. That's awk. But again, if they're playing Night March, I actually kind of want this dark ray, so we're gonna grab that. And then what is the standard format, or rather, what does it include? Standard includes a fewer number of sets. I am still very new to this game, so please don't ask me which sets it includes, because I can't actually tell you that. Alright, let's go ahead and max Elixir here. So that looks at the top six cards and grabs an energy and puts it onto one of our bench Pokemon. And then let's Dark Patch here and click this and put it onto our bench Pokemon. And then let's put this Dark Energy for a turn. Then we'll play Sycamore and draw seven cards. Large enough to have an SCG. I don't know if it's large enough to. Oh, the free letter is frustrating sometimes. It is funny, though. Maddie left, and we start having very reasonable hands. We also changed two cards, so maybe that's it, but, you know. And yeah, the actual just, like, official Pokemon tournaments, like their regional tournaments, are worth a reasonable amount of money. They're halfway through their year right now. The Pokemon tournament year goes from the beginning of July to the end of June. So, like, I'm not going to go deep or, you know, play a ton of them like I would. I'm just planning to attend the two regional tournaments that are within driving distance of my house. But if I'm still enjoying this game come July, I could reasonably see myself, like, attending enough of their tournaments to try and queue for one of their world's invites. Sounds fine. Kind of electric deck. Hydreon's actually probably going to be pretty good in this matchup, likely playing some kind of Jolteon strategy. We shall see. Hydreon is useful. People often ask me why I play this, because his Dragon Road ability isn't terribly great when we have the other Darkrai EX, but the fact that he ignores effects of attacks on Pokemon. Oh, this is the Raikou deck. Okay, got it. So usually they have a Raichu in or a Jolteon in there somewhere, but not always. All right, let's hit with that and put an energy over here, and then I can go ahead and slide this out, and I can go ahead and slide this out. Then I can play Shaymin here and drop six cards in my hand. And okay, yeah. Well, let's just go ahead and go. Boop, boop, and then go ahead and end. And again, that was another example of having Dark Patch in my hand without having anything, any Dark Energies in here to go get with it, which is a little awkward. I'm going to go ahead and Ultra Ball here and discard these two energies. Actually, there isn't really anything I need to get out of my deck. I guess I'll grab this Giratina for now, but I just want to be able to go ahead and play this Dark Patch out. So I'm going to go ahead and do that and start setting up the second Dark Ray. So I believe this does damage based on the amount of lightning energy on this. Yes, it does 20 more for each electric energy on here. And then this takes 20 less damage if it has lightning energy attached to it. So this has 120 hit points, but we basically got to hit it for 140. So right now we've got 1, 2, 3... So we're hitting for 60, 80, 90 right now, and we need to get up to 140, so we're currently some points short. end my hand away, that's fine. My hand's not particularly impressive. Would love another dark patch and a double dragon. Okay, we got a double dragon. We got a trainer's mail. That could be a dark patch. We got a verse seeker. That's an end of our own. Ray eels. Yeah, this is definitely the eels deck. So there's an evolution of this, I believe, that like lets him attach lightnings from his discard pile to his Pokemon. So he put a Fighting Fury belt on here, so now this is 160. Didn't have any energies to attach. Well, that's really unfortunate for him. I'm going to go ahead and lead on Trainer Mail here and see what we find. Escape Rope, Lysander. God, do I want any of these cards? I don't think I do. I'm just going to hit done. I'm going to go ahead and put this on here. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm hitting for 120, 130 right now. This is 160 minus 20. So I need to get 3 more energies onto things this turn if I want to be able to knock this out. I think I'm just going to go ahead and Sycamore here. The reason why I'm not going to Verse Seeker for the N is because I really don't want my opponent to get a better hand, because their hand seems like it's pretty bad right now. Just didn't do anything last turn. I'm going to go ahead and play this Parallel City out here to knock out their thing that heals their guy. And then this has a free retreat cost because the double dragon energy counts as a dark. So I'm going to swap back to here and then just go ahead and attack with my Dark Ray for 130 points. So I needed 2 more energies to be lethal that turn, so a little bit short. We know a little bit more than that, Chaotic Panda. They also announced that they were collaborating with people from like Direwolf Digital and other media firms like that. Would love another double dragon. Okay, this hand is not good. So there's their Electrid. Yep, lets them put lightnings from their discard pile onto their Pokemans. Pokemen and women. Howdy, David. So as I mentioned earlier, you're not going to be a super long stream tonight. Planning to go till, I don't know, another 2 or 3 games. So there's some more electrics that they've been. So they're going to get another evolution here for this and then stack this guy up, I bet. But they're going to be pretty far off. Like, this Darkrai's got 220 hit points. Ooh, we're just getting a second Raikou for the bench. Got it. And Fighting Fury Belt. And then our last card draws a bunch of cards, as always. No, they already drew a bunch of cards, right? This is an actual deck or more of a homebrew? Kind of a split down the middle. So I put this here. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is hitting for 140, 150. And this is lightning energy on it. I think I'm going to Lysander this one up. Just like get damages on both of these, rather than give him this and let him have open bench space. Yeah, the game's a lot of fun. It has a lot more depth than I was expecting when I first started playing. Direwolf Digital is also the company that makes the Pokemon TCG client that I'm playing on right now, for reference. So they're stacking more energies up onto this one here. You always kind of want to diversify when you are spreading your energies out. So, and it's also good to just have dark energies on all of your Pokemon because of this Darkrai EX. So I'm gonna go ahead and put another energy on there. And then again, I could N or I could Sycamore, but I really feel like one of the really important things when playing Pokemon is just like knowing when to stop doing things. And like, I don't really need to do anything to progress my game plan here, so I'm just not gonna do more stuff. PTCG. So, I guess it's similar in the aspect that a lot of what you're doing in Pokemon TCG is the way you interact in this game is like setting up lock pieces, basically. So like you don't, it's not like Magic or Eternal or Hex where like there's like instants and interrupts and things like that. The way you interact with your opponent instead of responding to their things is you're preemptively trying to interact with them by like attacking their resources directly and playing things that interact with the cards that they're using. Look at that. All that setup and you only did 120 points of damage. That's so sad. That's so very, very sad. I've said so many of the Pokemon's names wrong, correctly, and incorrectly for so long, I've kind of lost track of which ones I'm doing on purpose and which ones I'm not. Oh, the word Pokemon. No, I definitely say I'm saying the man at the end on purpose. Yeah, exactly. Which is similar to some vintage decks. So there go all of those. So like now the goal is just like set up running Raikus, right? And just like keep electricking them, electricking them full of energies every turn, so you can just like keep 120ing me. Opponent concedes because they don't have any more setup to do. Yeah, definitely. Someone that commented earlier, this looks like Turbo Dark with Dragon shoved into it. Yeah, that's basically what it is. The dragons give you another access to accelerate on because attaching double dragon energies allow you to add plus 40 to your Darkrai attack. So like instead of having 8 accelerants, you have 12 of them by utilizing your dragons. The dragons also allow you to have some utility and versatility. Salamence is a very powerful card. Hydreon lets you attack through cards that you wouldn't otherwise be able to get through without playing bad cards like Ranger. And Giratina locks some people completely out of the game. Can I give a quick little rundown of the TCG? You should check out this video. It will do you wonders to spend 10 minutes watching that as opposed to watching me fumble and explain the basics here, because I'll miss something and you'll still be confused, and the professor does a great job in that video. I mean, like, people always talk about grinding in games like this, and like, I'm not doing this for the free rewards. Like, I'm doing this to get like repetition in with the decks, and because like I find it amusing to play the game. Like the bonuses and the prizes you're earning while playing the game should be just that. They should be bonuses and extras, not like the reason you're playing it. Like if you're doing this because you feel like you need to earn something, you should probably just go like get a job and like have some actual money and then like buy a bunch of pack codes and buy the cards that you actually want to play. Like go, even a minimum wage job, you can go work that for, I don't know, 10 hours or so and then have more than enough money to buy most Pokemon decks. All right, another Night March deck. So what are we doing here? We've actually got an okay hand to set up. Let's start on the Nest Ball here. We'll be at the Roanoke Regional of Pokemon. I will not be. I live in the Midwest, so I am only, until next season, I'm only playing Pokemon events that are within reasonable driving distance of myself. Yeah, and I guess I'm just gonna get a Darkrai here. And I guess I can Ultra Ball into another thing. I don't need the Reverse Valley here. So I'm gonna bin these two. And actually, I guess this needs to get Shaymin, doesn't it? That's a little awk. Maybe I should have gotten a dragon so I had something to attach this double dragon to. Dark Patch. There's no dark in here, are there? Nope. So I'm gonna not take this Dark Patch because Shaymin will draw me an extra card this way. Slide that onto there. Go ahead and Shaymin. There's some dragons to play out. Getting Giratina set up is actually going to be very, very good because actually, do I even want an Espaul here? I don't really need another Dark Raid, do I? Yeah, I'd kind of rather wait and have this Shaman, I think, so I'm just going to no sir the Espaul and play this out. Although I guess maybe the other Dark Raid is better than that. Actually, do I even want a Sycamore? I don't really want a Sycamore, do I? Because I want this other Double Dragon to attach onto here. Yeah, I'm just going to pass. Which, if we get End, we feel a little bit medium, but. So, Giratina, when you Chaos Wheel, it locks your opponent out of playing Tools and Special Energies and Stadiums the following turn. So, like, this deck thrives on Double Colorless Energies. So, if, like, if we get Giratina up and just start, like, hitting them and, like, locking them out of playing Double Colorless Energies, they shouldn't be able to play the game, I don't think. Shaman of their own, sure. So my opponent's deck is built around setting up this Night March attack. This does 20 damage times the number of Pokemon in their discard pile that have the ability to attack Night March. So they're using this Battle Compressor card to like fill their discard pile with a bunch of Night March troops. So they've got 4, 5, 6, 7 Night March cards right now. So they're currently Night Marching for 140. How's it going, Rain? Good. So I was correct in setting this up then. And again, this is just like the random utility that the Giratina offers in the deck. And so, like, ideally, what happens next turn, we get like. I don't actually have a good way to retreat this currently next turn, so I might have to wait, like put Double Dragon on here and then wait. I guess I could hit an escape rope, but I don't have a way to actually attach an extra energy to this active one. So maybe I should have just Sycamored last turn and like hope to have found a dragon in another Double Dragon and 8 cards. Just mono muscle bands, okay. Knock my guy out, please. Knock my guy out, please. Knock my guy out, please. This is 8, 9. This is hitting for 180 right now. So this will be a lethal. Oh yeah, they're just hitting for infinite here. I don't have a Karen in this deck either, so like we'll see if they can beat this Giratina attacking every turn. Sure, man. They've got 9 cards or 10 cards left in their deck now. They're dead if they knock my guy out. He shouldn't. Yeah, I agree. He's like, get another one set up, right? I would really like. And this is doing plus 20 from the muscle band, too. So this is hitting for two, just a clean 200 right now. He needs to, like, wait and Lysander this up. Yeah, so he gets two prize cards here, but I'm pretty sure this Giratina locks him out of the game unless he's got a Pokemon Ranger in his expanded deck, which is pretty rare. Put a Fury Belt on here just in case. Slide Hydreigon out and then. Yeah, I'm just gonna Chaos Wheel. This is even with the Fighting Fury Belt one-shotting Shamans, which is nice. I didn't play the Parallel. Maybe was I supposed to play the Parallel City out there? Search your deck for Pokemon reveal. Maybe I'm supposed to play the Parallel City out there. Well, there's teammates, so if he's got a Ranger in his deck, he's gonna get it now. I guess I could theoretically have like an Enhanced Hammer, but I actually drew another Double Dragon energy here, so. Oh, fuck me. Yep, should have played out my stadium. So this.
Reduces this thing's attack. Yep. All right, I messed up. Yep, we messed up. So should have put stadium out. And then yep. I guess he's down to two prizes, so there's a world where. Oh, you know what? I even put up the wrong. I'm gonna go ahead and play this out. We'll go ahead and end. And there's a world where like I shuffle away his double colorless energies here. It's like he's only gonna get to draw two cards here and then one for the turn. So yeah, there's a world where like my opponent gets really unfortunate here. And like we win this game because I'm gonna draw five cards and they're only gonna draw two. But they do only have to knock out just this guy, so this guy sliding up there is gonna be more than enough to get me. Wow, four double dragons in hand, or four darks in hand, and actually hit on the elixir still. He's got more than enough fodder to just like slide out other cards if he doesn't hit the double colorless though. Lysander's actually a great pickup here. Could find Diverse Seeker or something to draw more cards. Yep. So this is going to be a Sycamore, which will let them get through seven of these cards out of 10. So, like, strong favorite to find another DCE. How many DCEs are in the crypt? Just one? Yeah, there's just one in there. Yep. Come on, bud. You've already got it in your hand. Oh, he had teammates there. So I knocked out one of his guys. So chance we get knocked out there if he has another stadium anyways, but certainly should have played out my Parallel City to bump his stadium to prevent what happened with the Mew there. Yeah, this hand's okay. It's got a level ball and an ultra ball to get rolling. Or nest ball and ultra ball to get rolling. He couldn't play another stadium because Giratina. Oh, jeez. You're so right. So we would have literally just locked him out then, huh? He would have had to attach single energies over the course of two turns. And if I would have hit a Lysander. My last name is pronounced Hoagland with a long O sound. Yep, you're very correct. Giratina will lock him out of that too. Okay. Man, what a big dumb stupid I am. All right, so let's go ahead and lead on Nest Ball here. Opponents led on Yevetal, so I'm gonna go ahead and grab this Salamence. You can go ahead and put this double dragon on here. I'm going to Ultra Ball, ditch these to grab Shaymin. Other Shaymin is prized, things worth noting. Have a good night, Priest. Go ahead and throw PC up here. That might slow him down if he's got Hoopa shenanigans to go on next turn. He haven't put any darks in there yet. There's some darks. So what am I doing here? I can Dark Ray. And then I think this is getting a Sycamore. I'm gonna go ahead and computer search here, bin these two. I'm gonna grab a Sycamore here. Actually, you know, I wonder if I should have a Geddes in this deck because like if I would have gotten a Geddes there, like very, very real chance that my opponent like just loses the game because I take all their items away while I'm on the play. Looking for elixirs and dark patches. Can the elixir hit? Never. Slide these bad boys out here. No reason to wait on them because we know our last shaman is prized. We're not going to need to do it. Start with medium there. Got accelerated one energy ahead. So this does damage based on the amount of energies attached to it and the opposing Pokemon. So ideally we want to be killing it with Dark Rays, because Dark Ray only needs two energies to attack. Shaman, so they can draw back up, sure. They've got weird. So they've got dark energy in the deck, but they're also... Okay, so they're just, like, playing this Mewtwo inside of... in with Yveltal. Interesting. So things worth noting here now are that... my opponent now has 1, 2, 3 EX Pokemon in play, which means this is now attacking for 160. So with a Fighting Fury belt, this will deal lethal attacks to this and this. Jirachi goes and gets them a supporter of their choice. Why do I need sleeves? I got this sweet Pokemon card back here. Delinquent. Knock my stadium out, and then I discard three cards. Sure. I will keep this draw seven. The old hit me for 20 because of resistance. Another double dragon. Yeah, that sounds quite lovely. So, unfortunately, I really can't do anything else this turn, so let's just pass. We're hoping to not get Lysandered here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is hitting for 140 right now. The double dragon. So the double dragons count as two energies of every type while they're attached to a dragon, which means it enables him to use these dragon attacks. But my dark ray attack does damage based on the amount of dark energy that's attached to all Pokemon I control. So because this double dragons count as every type, that includes dark. So that means this guy gets to count them twice. So basically, if this guy attacks, it counts as seeing six dark energies. I have no idea what they're setting up here. Hex Maniac really doesn't do anything. And he discarded two energies to retreat. It seems real loose. That's at 170. I think I'm just putting this on here. And then that's 6, 7. So this is sitting for 160 right now. And then I'm just going to go ahead and end, since I know my opponent has a Shaman in their hand anyways. Do I want to Ultra Ball just to thin some of these cards out of my deck? Yeah, I think I do, actually. I just, like, don't want to draw this Giratina or this other N, I don't think. So, yeah, I'm just going to hit done. Just, like, discard these three cards so I don't have to draw them. There's not a limit to the number of energies you can put on a single guy. And then, oh, he turned off Pokemon abilities. That turned off. Okay, I got it. So I'm slow, and that was relevant because he turned off the ability on this, which lets me retreat for free. Got it. We got there eventually. I'm going to go ahead and put this on the Salamence preemptively, just in case it gets attacked. And then I'm going to go ahead and play this Reverse Valley out in case they have Reverse Valleys of their own. I guess this is a liability if my opponent has a Verse Seeker for the Delinquent. So maybe that's a reason not to do this. This disables tools. As long as it's active, each Pokemon tool card has no effect. So this gets to do 60 here and 60 to something else. Probably gonna hit the Salamence, I'd imagine. Could also see it hitting this Darkrai that has energies on it. Have I ever gotten close to timing out? Nope, can't say that I have. It is 20 to midnight. This is going to be my last game of the night, folks. Thanks, everyone, for hanging out. Remember, if you want to see more Pokemon content, you can check out my YouTube channel that's linked in the stream information, and there's tons of hours of content on there. Lots and lots of Pokemon and Pokewomen. I have two tiny children that will be screaming at the hour of 7 o'clock or earlier, so I'll have to stay up too late. This is hitting for 200 plus. You are knocking guys off my bench. Huh, that's interesting. Well, we're definitely losing the Shaymin. And now the question is, do I want to lose the Hydreigon, or do I want to lose this? I kind of don't want to lose this, because then I lose my free retreat, so I guess I'm going to ditch the Hydreigon, but that doesn't mean I can't diversify my double dragons, which feels a little bit bad. So, depending on who he hits with this Yevital attack will determine who I'm... Oh, don't delinquent me. He already played it. I can't remember if they played a supporter or not this turn. So if he hits this, I'll put this up. Okay, he hits that. That's pretty smart. This guy is very quickly lethal. Let's lead on this, see what we get. Dark Patch, Escape Rope, Burst Seeker. I mean, I guess I can just end here. That seems fine. He already Sycamored. Good. Yeah, I'm going to grab the Verse Seeker. I guess I could just Sycamore myself. Do I really care? Does doing either of these really matter? I'm not sure that it does. We're once again in a position where I can't knock this stadium out, so perhaps I should have one more stadium in my deck. Ooh, I have a Lysander. Does that do anything? Not really. Possible I should just save this VS Seeker here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So this is hitting for 180, so that's plenty to knock his guy out. So let's just go ahead and slide this up here and then give him the old wham bam, thank you, ma'am. And then we can just, like, slide on down the line, knocking his EXs out one at a time here. How many Verse Seekers are there? There's three Verse Seekers in my bin already, and one Lysander. Yeah, it's possible I should play a Delinquent. And like, he's put an energy on here now. How many Fighting Fury Belts am I through out of curiosity? None? One? I've only played one? That's interesting. So computers are chairs, so they get to go get anything they want out of their deck. I don't think they can knock this out. They could... Oh, they're going to get a Lysander, aren't they? Fuck. So if he gets a Lysander... Oh, he discarded a Lysander. So if he gets two energies on here, or what if he puts double colorless on here, that's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this would do 160, which would exactly knock this out. So if he has DCE plus a Lysander this turn, he can kill my Salamence, which would be bad for me. Three DCEs in here. I don't know if they play four. So that increases our chances a little bit. Another shame. What are we doing? We're just like drawing. He must not have a fourth DCE in there. Okay, now we're compressoring to thin our deck a little bit here so we can draw the cards we want.
Yeah, I feel like I shouldn't have end last turn, and I should have just, like, waited and held the Verse Seeker for a Lysander for after I knocked this guy out here. Probably prized, yep. Dark Patch, sure. Okay, so if he has, like, Dark Patch plus a Dark Energy plus a Lysander, double Dark Patch Lysander will do it. So if he has a Lysander here, he can kill my Salamence. Then we're probably locked out of this game. Are both my other dragons in here? They are. So, that's... Yep, there's the Lysander. I feel like my opponent has made a sizable mistake here. Right? Because this is... Yeah, they could have knocked this out. And then we would almost certainly never win this game. Pretty sure they just kicked the ball. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Put a Fury Belt down here. Attack for lethal. Yeah, so if my opponent takes the right line there, I'm pretty sure we can never win the game, but they didn't, so now we likely are. So my opponent, instead of ending there, should have Lysandered this up and knocked it out. They could have dealt 160 exactly to it. No, there's a Lysander in here. He discarded it to the Ultra Ball earlier. It's right there. He had multiple chances to do it. And there's the other double colorless energy too. So that wasn't prized either. So I'm just super confused as to all of the decisions that they've made. I feel like we definitely should not have won this game. I'm just gonna get end again, sure. I don't know what you're looking for. It's in these three cards, it's not in your hand, bud, but more power to you, I guess. It doesn't even kill my guy. That's so sad for him. Yeah, just... Alright, so... We shouldn't have won that game, but we did, you know? Sometimes your opponent makes mistakes and you win the game. Sometimes you make sweet plays and you win the game, so... At any rate, folks, thanks everyone for hanging out. I'm gonna go ahead and get this archive uploaded now. We played for about an hour and a half, so if you missed any of the start, the archive will be up on my YouTube channel by the morning. I will catch y'all later. If you have any suggestions for my decks, feel free to tweet them at me or post them as YouTube comments on the videos. This is a bit of a mix of a tiered deck and something I've been working on. I think Nest Ball could be reasonable in it. We started with four, we're down to two, maybe, you know. We'll see. I will be back tomorrow afternoon playing some Hex TCG, and then tomorrow night with my Paper Magic stream that we do a couple times a month, and then Wednesday afternoon we'll be back with more Pokemon TCG if Pokemon is your TCG of choice. So catch you Wednesday if you're Pokemon, tomorrow if you're a Hex, and tomorrow night if you're a Magic player. So peace.